Hi students, so Seema, so we have completed with the measures of central tendency. In the measures of central tendency, what are the topics I have covered? My about mean, I have covered median, okay, mode, weighted arithmetic mean we have covered, combined mean, corrected mean, harmonic mean, okay, those all things we have covered under measures of central tendency, okay. So here measures of central tendency, measures of dispersion, skewness, kurtosis, four chapters are there in unit 2 ma. So in unit 2 we have completed one chapter, and next we are going to discuss with the measures of dispersion. So in the measures of dispersion, again here we have a different topics. So here under measures of dispersion, today we are going to discuss with the range. So here in measures of dispersion, here we have range, quartile deviation, mean deviation, standard deviation, and coefficient of variation. So these are the topics we are going to discuss under measures of dispersion. Okay, once again, listen carefully. In the measures of dispersion, how many topics we have? Means 5 topics we have. That is range, quartile deviation, mean deviation, standard deviation, and coefficient of variations. So these are the topics we are going to cover under the dispersion. Okay, so today I am going to discuss with the range. In range, I am going to discuss with the individual series, discrete series, and continuous series. So first you see here, what is a range? So it is the simplest of the value of dispersion. It is merely the difference between the largest and smallest term. Okay, so it is nothing but here we have to calculate the range between largest and smallest, nothing but the range between the small value and the largest value. So that we are going to discuss. So what is the formula for the range you see here? So range is equal to L minus S. This is the formula for range ma. So range is equal to L minus S, means largest value minus smallest, largest term or largest value, smallest term or smallest value. And one more formula we have here, that is coefficient of range. So coefficient of range is equal to L minus S by L plus S. Okay, nothing but largest value minus smallest, largest value plus smallest. Then you will be getting, after dividing it, you will be getting a coefficient of range. Okay, so now we are going to see the first individual series. So same like mean, median, mode, here also we have individual series, discrete series, and continuous series. So now we are going to discuss with the individual series. First you see, find range and coefficient of range for the following data he has given. So this, by seeing this series, we can say that this is an individual series. So from now this series, we have to find the range and coefficient of range also. So how to find the range here? What is the formula of range ma? L minus S, means largest minus smallest value. So here in this series, once you observe this series ma, in this series, which is the largest value here, 37 is the largest value, and which is the smallest value, 14 is the smallest value. So L is equal to 37 and S is equal to 14. So what is the range formula here? L minus S. So range is equal to 37 minus 14, means how much? 23 we got. So range we have, range answer is how much? 23. Next we are going to calculate with the coefficient of range. So coefficient of range is equal to L minus S by L plus S. So 37 minus 14 by 37 plus 14, 23 by 51. So how much we got here? 0.451. Okay, so this is a range in case of individual series. Next we are going to see the discrete series. So find the range and coefficient of range for the following data. So here X he has given and F he has given. Okay, so X and F, by seeing this we can say that this is a discrete series. Which series it is? It is a discrete series. So now in this discrete series, see here ma, so find range and coefficient of range he has given. So X he has given and F he has given. So by this we can say that this is a discrete series. So in case of discrete series here, we have to see only X. We have to see only in X. In X, which is a higher value, once you see, X is the largest value. Which is the largest value you see here? So here 40 is the largest value. 40 is the largest value and 5 is the smallest value. So L is there and S is there. So now first of all, range. What is the range formula? L minus S. So 40 minus 5. That is 35 we got. Next, coefficient of range. L minus S by L plus S. So 40 minus 5 by 40 plus 5. So 35 divided by 45. You got 0.778. So this is discrete. Next we are going to discuss with the continuous series. So calculate range and coefficient of range from the following data he has given. So in case of continuous series, class intervals will be there, frequency will be there. But here we have to observe only class intervals. In case of range, here we have to observe only class intervals. So in the class intervals, the highest value is, largest value is how much, ma? 80, and the smallest value is how much? 20. F, you should not touch at all F. Only you have to see here class intervals. So L is how much? 80, and S is how much, ma? 20. So 80 minus 20, range formula. What is the range? L minus S. So 80 minus 20, how much we got here? 60. Next, what we have to do? We have to find the coefficient of range. So coefficient of range formula, L minus S by L plus S. So 80 minus 20 by 80 plus 20. So 60 by 100 is equal to 0.6 we got. So this is range in case of measures of dispersion. So in range, here we have discussed individual series, discrete series and continuous series. Okay now?